Talk by Father Jeremy Habarimana. Forgive others and Jesus Christ forgive you. First Thursday of Lent. Readings. First reading. Accept your contrite heart and humble spirit. A reading according to Daniel's prophecy 3, verse 25, 34 to 43. Azariah stood up in the fire and prayed aloud. For your name's sake, O Lord, do not deliver us up forever, or make void your covenant. Do not take away your mercy from us, for the sake of Abraham, your beloved, Isaac your servant, and Israel your holy one, to whom you promised to multiply their offspring like the stars of heaven, or the sand on the shore of the sea. For we are reduced, O Lord, beyond any other nation brought loud everywhere in the world this day, because our sins. We have in our day no prince, prophet, or leader, no burnt offering, sacrifice, oblation, or incense, no place to offer first fruits, to find favor with you. But with contrite heart and humble spirit, let us be received, as thought it were burnt offerings of rams and bulldogs, or thousands of fat lambs. So let our sacrifice be in your presence today, as we follow you unreservedly, for those who trust in you cannot be put to shame, and how we follow you with our whole heart, we fear you and we pray to you. Do not let us be put to shame, but deal with us in your kindness and great mercy. Deliver us for your wonders and bring glory to your name, O Lord. Responsorial Psalm, Psalm 24. Response: Remember your mercies, O Lord. Your ways, O Lord, make known to me. Teach me your path, guide me in your truth, and teach me, for you are my God, my Savior. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Remember that your compassion, O Lord, and your wickednesses are from old. In your kindness, remember me, because of your goodness, O Lord. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord. Thus he shows sinners the way. He guides the humble to justice. He teaches the humble his way. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Acclamation before the Gospel. Even now, says the Lord, return to me with your whole heart, for I am gracious and merciful. Gospel. If anyone does not heartbroken forgive his brother, neither will the Father forgive you. A reading of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew 18, verse 21 to 35. Peter approached Jesus and asked him, Lord, if my brother sins against me, how often must I forgive him? As many as seven times? Jesus answered, I say to you, not seven times, but 77 times. That is why the kingdom of heaven might be likened to a king who decides to settle accounts with his servants. When he began the accounting, a debtor was brought before him who owed him a huge amount. Since he had no way of paying it back, his master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, his children, and all his property, in payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down, did him homage, and said, Be patient with me, and I will pay you back in full. Moved with compassion, the master of that servant let him go and forgave him the loan. When that servant had left, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him and started to coax him, demanding, Pay back what you owe. Falling to his knees, his fellow servant begged him, Be patient with me, and I will pay you back. But he refused. Instead, he had him put in prison until he paid back the debt. Now, when his fellow servants saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed, and went to their master and reported the whole affair, his master summoned him and said to him, "You wicked servant, I forgave you the entire debt because you begged to me. Should not have had pity on your fellow servant as I have pity on you." Then, in anger, his master handed him over to the tortoise until he should pay back the whole debt. "So will my father, heavenly father, do to you, unless each of you forgives your brother for your heart." Talk. Dear brothers, the Lord always shows himself not only to teach us, but to transform us. Today it comes full of power, of mercy, to transform revenge, anger, all the evil we have, and we justify because others also have it. Jesus Christ teaches us to forgive from the heart and presents itself to transform our hearts, to fill us with forgiveness. There are different reasons for revenge and few to forgive in the eyes of the world, but it is not for your Jesus Christ. The reason to forgive in us, it is because we also want to be forgiven. No one wants to be punished. Jesus Christ says to us, "Ah, do you want to be forgiven? That's good, for he forgives others too." To all who want to be forgiven, the Lord calls you to forgive and gives you that gift. For this forgiveness, it only comes from the heart of Jesus Christ. No one can forgive, but he gives it to him by heaven. It is Jesus Christ himself who died for the weaknesses of man, the one who frees us from that evil. Merciful Jesus Christ, full of kindness, look at us lovingly and wants to transform us. Love us filled with mercy, for he wants to live with us eternally. And without mercy, we cannot be near him. We ourselves feel to the not being able to bear that love. There are people who think someone forgiving everyone, don't understand him, and turn away from him. They insult him. They persecute him because he's imitating Jesus. Forgive is a gift that Jesus Christ gives us. We must ask him continually, "Lord Jesus, I want to forgive, and always forgive, at all times, every person. Give me that gift, Lord Jesus Christ. You who forgive everyone, teach me, transform me so that I too can forgive everyone." All who forgive receive a reward, as Jesus Christ says, "Blessed are the merciful, for they shall receive mercy." It is an automatic thing. If someone forgives their lifelong enemy, something happens. Not forgiving is a closed door to being forgiven, to Easter joy, to hope, to all the gifts of the Holy Spirit. There is also a lot of people praying, trying to sanctify themselves, but they don't want to forgive. Then you will never experience anything different in your life because the door of life is closed by the lack of forgiveness. It is for our sake to forgive others. Jesus Christ, our example, has forgiven us. It is our model, and it gives us strength. It encourages us. Why don't we want to imitate our Lord Jesus Christ if we really are his disciples? Let us leave for the devil the lack of forgiveness, because the devil's other name is "I will never forgive." My name is "I will never forgive." Mercy is the demonic realm does not exist. If someone says, "I will never forgive," it is not the Holy Spirit who speaks. Sanity is the enemy that is invited him. When we forgive many demons in the name of Jesus Christ, there are many bonds that break. There is a life that starts. Happy those who forgive from heart. Jesus Christ must be continually asked of Jesus Christ. It is the life that Jesus Christ gives us. It is His holiness that begins in this world. It is happiness. Not one is happy if he does not forgive in the name of Jesus Christ. Blessed are those who forgive. Forgive your heart. Jesus Christ said, not only with words, but by heart. That's a gift. May the The Holy Spirit take possession of our life, the Spirit of mercy, of kindness, of forgiveness, the Spirit of Jesus Christ Himself, to transform us, fill us with mercy, love, kindness. Always forgive with joy in the name of Jesus Christ. Come, Holy Spirit, Immaculate Heart of Mary, protect us. Glory to you, merciful Jesus Christ, you who call us to forgive you, that you may us forgive. You who fill us with your mercy and your goodness. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.